spending their lives and having them respond using their weapon. Is there a racial component? Is there a racial component? I don't believe so at all. There's no facts to support that race is involved when someone points a gun at you.
I'm sorry, I agree.
I'm trying to answer, please.
We're not going to let you shout down the panel. No one's shouting. Sir, please, you are a guest in a church. Show respect.
Are also black or Latino. So, the facts are right there.
Some of the things that I deal with is obviously our homicides in this city. The majority of our homicide victims are African American. The majority of the suspects are African American. In Dixon Circle, like I mentioned, the 6 square-mile block of the neighborhood, 91 people have been killed. Victims have been African American. The majority of the suspects have been African American. Since the Harper shooting, we've had more than 16 other African Americans killed by other African Americans.
These are my friends.
The issue is our murders, irregardless of whether an officer uses his weapon, the majority of our murders in this city is just too high.
That's what
the lowest in 50 years, but
they
if you're that family member, that's one is too many. And so we need your help in this community to help us with this issue of violence, particularly violence where the obviously in the neighborhoods that you're mentioning where African Americans are the people killing other African Americans. And that's a tough way to say it, but it's the facts of what's happening. That's unsustainable in any neighborhood and not acceptable. Of course, the grand jury looks at every shooting where an officer uses weapon and someone dies. And they are independent of the police department. The police department does not sit on the grand jury.